He's committed to the Pats for 2017, despite the sides not reaching a long-term contract extension. Pats signed cornerback Stephon Gilmore to a top-of-the-market five-year, $65 million deal. And look who's here in Bristol. It's the peripatetic Jeff here. Darlington. You're actually a real person.
Yes.
It's good to see you here. What does him being there mean for his future with the Patriots?
Well, it's such a good story already, Hannah. And I remember Matthew Slater saying this season that this is one of the best stories in football over the last few decades. And I sort of agree with that. I mean, considering what he did in the Super Bowl and then getting to the point where now he's in a situation to eventually get paid. Now, I was told by a Saints source that what happened here with that potential trade was that it simply lost steam, and it was overcompensation.
This is with the Saints, right?
This is with the Saints, yes. And ultimately, the Patriots decided, hey, we're going to keep our Pro Bowl guy. We don't feel the need to unload him. I'm not saying that something couldn't eventually happen. I don't anticipate it happening with the Saints.
Doesn't that give them one of the best cornerback tandems in the league?
It does. An outstanding Stephon Gilmore, as well as Malcolm Butler. So, look, this secondary could be making another run toward that Super Bowl.
The Bills fire GM Doug Whaley. We've heard all sorts of things that have been going on with the Bills. They also fired the entire scouting staff, and then we had the Sammy Watkins news. I know you've been talking to people around that organization. What have you learned about those firings?
Well, first of all, they're going to face a challenge with their new general manager, and I want to explain a little bit into why. I was speaking with one former Bills scout who told me that they were essentially called into meetings at 8:30 a.m. on Sunday, the day after the draft. It was 18 of them. Some of their key cards didn't even work to get into the building, so quickly they realized exactly what was happening here. Some security guards were coming up, explaining to them that they needed to get their stuff, and they essentially said, can we first meet to find out what's going on? They eventually find out that 18 of them have been laid off. And I give that visual imagery because this is the task that the next general manager is going to have to face. He's going to have to hire an entire staff of scouts. That's not easy to do. I've spoken to a number of scouts over the past, or I should say executives over the past few weeks that have told me it's frustrating to try to fill out your scouting department because you can't easily hire a guy from another team. They can essentially say, we're not granting you permission to interview one of our guys unless it's a clear promotion. So this is not going to be an easy task for the Bills general manager.
When did they have to do it by? I mean, ostensibly, they should be doing it right away, right?
You would like to have it done by the time that you're making those 53-man roster cuts at the end of training camp. It's not going to be easy for the Bills to do that.
Wow. I don't think people really realize how many people that involves, how big that staff was. The Dolphins, they take a Missouri defensive end, Charles Harris, with a 22 pick. And at his draft party, he had an interesting guest. Can you explain, please?
Well, the question is who the guest was. Yes. I think that Trey Wingo, actually, after he pointed out that Chewbacca was there, I actually emailed Trey and was like, outstanding call there right away. It turns out that both me and Trey were completely wrong. That is not Chewbacca. That is a Sasquatch, it turns out.
Clearly.
He was there promoting a beef jerky brand, I guess some sort of, I guess Trey really messed that up for the beef jerky brand, though, because he thought it was Chewbacca.
Wow.
But apparently, Chewbacca has facial hair. And the Sasquatch has a receding hairline. This is what I've learned since. But
that is as a reporter, that is leaving no stone unturned.
We had to dig
there.
Deep for that one.
I'm really glad that you came back with that clarification.
Yeah, Pulitzer winning stuff.
Yeah. Oh yes, it is. Jeff Darlington, great to have you here. We'll see you on Insiders
Thank you, Hannah.
Later today.